How do you handle your sludge? Maybe no one knew that excess sludge needs to be removed regularly before it ends up in the sand filters. Maybe folks figured this was normal procedure. Maybe there are other demands on available funds that put hauling a little further down on the list. Hauling sludge costs money. How can we make the sludge go away without spending so much money and still be legal? This plant treated less than 5,000 gallons per day. For plants under 20,000 gallons per day, we came up with a pretty inexpensive way to handle sludge. It uses poly feed bags from the local feed mill at 50 cents each, a sump pump for about $100, some spare garden hose, a poly chemical drum from the local water plant, and a little polymer at about $50 a quart for a total investment of less than $250. First, you need something to support the bags and some place to drain the water, preferably back into the plant. In this case, it just drained back into the aeration tank. As you can see, we spared no expense on the pump. Since we had two pumps, we placed one in the mixing drum and one in the bottom of the clarifier. This made our fill and dump cycles quicker. It doesn't take much polymer to do the job. Make up a 1/4% solution with 10 mils of polymer into a gallon of water. Mix well and allow it to age for at least half an hour. Overnight is better. This mixture can be used until it turns green from the bacteria, then discard. We turned off the RAS pumps for a couple of hours to thicken the sludge in the clarifier to about 3/4% solids. When the drum is about 2/3 full, add 500 mils of the aged polymer mixture into the stream. Don't add it too fast. This helps mix everything. You should see the flocks form about the size of popped corn and very clear water in between the flocks. Start filling the bags and quickly see the clear water droplets form on the outside of the bag. Each bag holds about 17 gallons of sludge. We filled these bags in the afternoon, and about 18 hours later, here's what we saw. That 3/4% solid sludge now was 10% solids. At this point, the bags could be refilled or dumped into garbage bags for disposal in the dumpster. The poly bags could be rinsed and reused. We made these shapes to show how thick the sludge became overnight. The sludge is now able to hold different shapes. We converted 800 gallons of 3/4% sludge to 600 pounds of 10% sludge with an investment of less than $250. Get the job done using an effective method.